Hello everybody and welcome back to Good Morning Sri Lanka. Well, we had to say bye-bye to our SFM presenters, but the good news is we've got Amaya in the studio this Monday morning. Good morning, Amaya.
Good morning, Vasal. I haven't seen you in a while.
Well, I know. I've been busy, a little stressed out too. But you know, this morning being a Monday morning, Amaya, well, they do say that, you know, Monday is considered one of the most stressful days of the week. Now, we've got an expert here in the studio to find if that's actually true and what stress is all about. Mm-hmm. So let's introduce you to him. He's Dr. Mahesh Rajasuriya. He is a consultant psychiatrist for the National Hospital, and also he is a senior lecturer of the Colombo University. So good morning, Doctor, and thank you for being with us this morning.
Thank you for having me here.
Well, is it true, Doctor, that Mondays are the most stressful, you know, people say it's the most stressful day of the entire week. What do you have to say about that?
Mm-hmm. It depends on many factors. Perhaps we need to understand what stress is first.
Of course.
It's a word that has been overused and probably abused, and many people do not know what it really means.
And also an excuse, right?
It is. It has become. Stress, technically speaking, has two components. Stressor and the reaction to stressor. Mm-hmm. Stressor means what brings about the stress, like, you know, the one who creates is creator, like the what brings about stress is stressor, just adding or at the end. So
that's
anything,
stressor.
Mm-hmm. Right, anything that brings usually it's something that happens to us. Mm-hmm. Say for an example, you lose your job. So that is something that brings a lot of pressure and, you know, negative emotions and negative outcomes to your life.
Of course.
So that is a stressor. Mm-hmm. It could be something very small, like you're having to catch a bus or a train given time, and you have to, you know, make sure that you are there on time and catch the train. So it may be even more simpler, like, you know, answering a phone. So when the phone is ringing, it's a bit of a stressor. It puts a bit of pressure on you. Now need to get ready and answer the phone. So that is stressor. And when that happens to you, you give a reaction. You react to that. You respond to that stressor. That is called the reaction to stressor. Mm-hmm. Very simple. Mm-hmm. So if it's a phone call, you may get up, pick the phone up, and get ready to answer the phone call. If you lose your job, you might lock yourself up in a room and cry for 4 days, or, you know, whatever. or you may just start hunting for another.
I need to stop you there, Doctor. You said cry for 4 days, but isn't crying actually something to de-stress yourself?
It is. But what you do is that, and that is called the reaction to the stressor.
I see.
Right? Time duration depends on the person.
It doesn't matter.
Are you saying that the reaction can actually help you manage the stress?
Of course.
I see.
That's what I'm trying to get at. So the stressor and the reaction to stressor together are known as stress.
I see. All right.
So those are the two components of stress. So it's not only what happens to you, mm-hmm. it's what you do as well, which is perhaps more important than what happens to you.
But I think we touched on the idea of the fact that people are now abusing this concept of stress, and it has really become a reason for so many things that people are giving nowadays when they want to put off some work, or they have to give an excuse for something mediocre. They say, I was too stressed out. But stress is something that's cropping up a lot these days, and it's a concept that's pretty new, I would say. So why do you think that that pattern is now, and that trend is now becoming more apparent, mm-hmm. Doctor?
The concept may be new, but what is really meant by stress has been there all the time.
Of course, yes.
Prehistoric ages, people had to, you know, hunt, mm-hmm. and when a tiger jumps in front of them, and that was a huge stressor, and they had to respond. Mm-hmm. They had to either run away or fight the tiger and kill the tiger. So that was an example of stressor and reacting to stressor. So it has been there all the time, ever since life began on Earth. But nowadays, we feel that stress is too frequent, or it's all the time. We are overwhelmed by stress and all that. There is some truth in it, because we have the world has become a place where there are additional sources of stress which were not there some time back. Mm-hmm. We can do a deep analysis on that, but if I give you just a simple example, having a mobile phone, right, is very helpful, but it keeps ringing. And you are talking to somebody, and now you have to pay attention to the conversation you are having with the person, and the person, and the respect the person, and then the phone is ringing. So you have limited time, and you have to give attention to too many stimuli, and that is more stressful. Because so many stressors happening at the same time. The other person is asking an important question and the phone is ringing.
Yes.
Right? So it's not easy. So with these kind of things, the life was much less slowly paced some time back. You didn't have the phone ringing all the time. Mm-hmm. So that's one reason why it has become apparently more or frequently reminding us that you are under stress. Another thing is that it has become fashionable to talk about stress, and the word stress has been invented and people talk about it, so people think that I have a lot of stress.
I mean, yeah, that's true, doctor, because for the slightest thing you hear people saying that I'm stressed out because of that or this, you know. So which goes on to my next question: what are the degrees of stress? Are there different categories? Is there a certain level of stress? Maybe particular level could be dangerous, or there could be a minor level, which is, you know, not too bad.
Stress is a normal phenomenon. It's not a disorder. It's not a disease. Mm-hmm. We all have stress, and perhaps the only way not to have stress is to be dead or unconscious, right? So the levels of stress. Now, that's a difficult question to answer. There have been studies which have analyzed the level of the degree of stressors, which is easier to study. Mm-hmm. So people have studied and categorized, you know, say for an example, death of a loved one is a stress of a highest degree.
Of course.
Losing your job comes somewhat next, and you know, getting a traffic ticket may be one of the least stressors, right? But to categorize stress is very difficult, because it has two components. The stressor is one, and the reaction to stressor is the other thing. Now, say for the traffic ticket, one person may freak out and become very angry and then drives very fast and knocks somebody.
Okay.
And kills somebody, right? Now he is in a huge stress, he or she is, right? Another person for the same stressor might just laugh it off and okay, I'll pay it and you know, I'll not do this again.
What you're basically saying is it's really psychologically how you look at the situation.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and how you react. How you look at it, yes. How you look at it and then how you react. So that decides the degree of overall stress to a much higher level than what stress would. So you can't just say it's a big stressor, but stressor would, right? So just because it's a big stressor, you can't say the stress would be big too. It can be low. And it can be the other way around as well.
We're speaking about stress in a very negative way, but is there some instances where you can say that stress is good and stress plays a positive role?
Stress is good.
Is right? Good. All
stress
right.
Stress is good. Now, the best part of stress is it makes us perform. Mm-hmm. Now, if we have a slide, I think, coming up. If we look at this first slide, it shows us the relationship between stress and performance. Mm-hmm. So, when you have no stress, you have no performance.
But then, doctor, is that the slide that you've been talking about?
The other one, I think, the curve, the graph, where it shows that, you know, on the horizontal axis we have stress, the level of stress.
All right.
And on the vertical axis we have performance. So when you have no stress, your performance is also zero, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, none of us would be learning the language of Mongolia. Because we don't have any pressure to do
so
that.
Basically what you're saying, stress can be a positive thing because it can be a motivator.
It is. Yes, it can be a very powerful motivator. And when you have a little bit of a pressure, you start performing, you start doing things. You say it may be an exam, you want to do a job better, or you want to achieve something. So you start performing, you start working, you start maybe studying, you start reading or you start gathering information mm-hmm. or experience. And when you increase the stress, the performance increases.
Okay.
If you ask bosses, they would tell you the more pressure you put, the more output you get.
I see.
But it doesn't go on like this indefinitely.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, it means that if you put a maximum pressure on a person, you would get maximum performance.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, that's not the case. When you go on increasing pressure or stress, at a point, the graph starts to dip down. It was going up and up and up. More stress, more performance.
Mm-hmm.
More stress, more performance. More and more stress, more and more performance. But when it reaches a particular level, it starts coming down.
Okay.
More stress, less performance.
Mm-hmm.
Even more stress, even less performance. And it can reach a time, it can reach a level of stress where performance is now zero. So
and
that
that's
happens
when things get really bad.
Yes. So that's a bad part of
mm-hmm,
it.
Mm-hmm.
So the middle and the you know, the left hand side of from the middle are best. You know, the middle part is the best, which is called U stress, the ideal level of stress. So you perform at your best.
I see.
All right. Right now we have to go for a very short break, I'm afraid, Doctor. But after the break, we will speak into you more about how stress can affect our bodies and the ways of different ways of combating stress. That's going to come up right after the break. But do stay with us here on Good Morning Sri Lanka.